Pakistan has experienced the worst flooding in the country's history this summer.
A climate catastrophe unfolding in Pakistan.
Over 30 million people are affected by unprecedented flooding in the country.
One of the biggest reasons behind the extreme flooding might be the same reason that Yangtze River is drying up. The scale of the flooding in Pakistan this year is absolutely unprecedented. But the country is no stranger to this type of natural disaster. In 1950, floods claimed more than 2,000 lives and submerged almost 18,000 square kilometers of land. But this year's floods have left at least one-third of the country underwater, displacing about 33 million people and killing nearly 1,400. So why is the flooding this year so extreme? And is climate change to blame? ExplaiNing! 2022 has one of the hottest summers on record worldwide, that's for sure. In countries like India and Pakistan, heat waves started as early as March. This early, prolonged, and record-setting heat waves may have foreshadowed the flooding that was to come. And here's the theory. Warmer air holds more moisture. For every degree Celsius the atmosphere warms, it can hold about 6 to 7% more moisture, which often results in more rain falling during the most extreme events. So Pakistan, as one of the hottest countries in the world, and with its city of Jacobabad becoming the hottest city on Earth on May 14, 2022, when temperatures hit 51 degrees Celsius, is a typical example. Pakistan also has more than 7,000 glaciers in its north mountainous regions, the most in the world beside the polar regions. The intense heat this year caused an excessive number of glaciers to melt, adding more glacial lakes to the roughly 3,000 already in existence, 33 of which are close to bursting. So the amount of water flowing into the Indus River, which runs from the Himalayas from Pakistan's north to the Arabian Sea in the south, far exceeded expectations. And one other driver is the anomalous monsoon season this year. But we can't talk about this problem without mentioning another natural disaster, the drought in the Yangtze River Basin. Normally, monsoon currents in the North Indian Ocean sweep into China from the west, merge with the easterly wind of the Pacific Ocean to form a typhoon, and merge with cold air to form a rain band called Meiyu. But this year, the Pacific Ocean and East Asia have been continuously shrouded by subtropical high pressure, which has shut out the monsoon. Instead, it turned to Pakistan. So the water vapor that was supposed to arrive in the Yangtze River Basin arrived in Pakistan, resulting in record-breaking rainfall and contributing largely to Yangtze River's lowest water level in 61 years.
This pagoda is usually surrounded by water. Now, the lake is gone, leaving this completely visible.
We can see that climate change has played a role in amplifying this disaster. And Pakistan is ground zero for the ongoing climate crisis. While this year's disasters may be the result of an abnormal climate pattern, as the planet keeps warming up and global climate anomalies become more pronounced, extreme weather events like intense rainfall and severe drought could become a lot more frequent. A joint effort from all countries, such as international fundings, is important. Because after all, this isn't just a problem for Pakistan. It's a problem for the entire world.
Today, it is Pakistan. Tomorrow, it could be your country. Thank you.
That's it for today, and thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give us a thumb up. And if you would like to get more content from us in the future, remember to smash that subscribe button. And remember to turn on notifications.